Hello everyone, and welcome to my new video series called Production Values, I think. I may change it by the time this video hits. But anyway, yes, this is a very simple premise. I am going to take a look at the production values of various wrestling companies and rate them on a scale. Of course, if I am going to rate a company such as OVW, I'm not going to use the same standards that I'd use for a company that is like WWE, because of course they don't have the money to produce something as polished and good looking. Anyway, if you're familiar with OVW, you know it either for the Netflix show that recently went out, or because it's been the developmental system for WWE many years ago and produced talents such as, I don't know, Ryback, I don't remember the others. For this video, I am going to use their more recent episode as of the time of this video, 2558, A New World, which is the episode that published just after the release of the documentary on Netflix. I will start from the positives. As I said, I know it's an indie, so for example, I will not complain about like the lack of a huge stage or anything. It's something that many of these smaller indie companies have to deal with, but in this case, the ring doesn't really have any problems that I can find. Like, the ropes are a bit loose, but sometimes indie companies will use rings that are slightly either smaller or shorter than what they should be, and this looks kinda low rent. Again, for indies, it's not something that I can blame them, but in this case, the ring, as I've seen, it looks good. You know, it looks up to par, so to speak. And that's probably because they are using the same ring that they were given by WWE when the company was a developmental system. You can see, like, branding on the canvas, on the commentary table. It's not on the turnbuckles, but it's not a big deal. You can see the logo somewhere around the arena. It's all relatively well done. I like the logo, actually. It's a really nice looking logo. I don't know if it's a new one or if, again, it's something that they carried over from their WWE days, but I like the look of it. Microphones and cameras are of passable quality. I've seen indies which recently especially have much better cameras and microphones, but as far as understanding what's going on during live segments where people have to talk in front of a crowd, I didn't have trouble understanding what they were saying, and the camera work, since it's not a live show, didn't miss anything. Was actually kinda decent for what it is in terms of capturing the action and anything. So yeah, another positive on OVW's side. One interesting thing that I noticed during the show is that it's full of sponsors. There is so many of them, and I was impressed because, again, like, we're not talking about some major promotion that is seen by hundreds of thousands of people, even after the Netflix documentary. Like, the funny thing is, these aren't like affiliate links that OVW is using to kinda look more professional, like in the case of my previous video about San Marino Wrestling School. These are actually legit sponsors, with wrestlers doing all the presentations and such. I mean, good for them, you know, like, it's a bit annoying when you have to go through an episode, but it's good that they're making money, you know? I can't hate on that, even if it's mildly affecting my viewing experience. The entranceway is a classic black curtain, no pyro, no anything. There is a tiny ramp, if I'm not mistaken, interdator, it's a ladder. It's fine for what it is, again, given the budget of the company. I can't complain much about something like that. What I can complain about is the graphics for the whole episode that I've seen. You know, the intro, the Titantrons, the match graphics. It all looks clearly taken from some sort of library of templates for After Effects or whatever editing program they're using. It doesn't look like it was custom made. You can see it especially when comparing the font used for certain graphics and the graphics themselves. It clearly looks jarring. Something that kind of annoyed me, even if it's, again, we're not talking huge fuck-ups in this video, but one thing that really I don't like, it's a big pet peeve of mine, it's the fact that the hard cam angle is really, really bad. Like, it's the crowd is uneven because of the seat placement and the fact that you have these two pillars that are used for the lighting setup. It's I don't know if it's because like those pillars are like permanently planted into the ground or what it is, but it makes the crowd look very uneven and much smaller than what it could possibly be, because I mean, from the looks of it, they have sold out the place, and it doesn't look all that good on camera. And the funniest thing is that if you look at the crowd shots behind the Artka, it looks a lot better than what we see for most of the night. Like, there seems to be more people, the pillars are less in the way. Of course, it's hard to tell because there is no clear shot, at least in the episode that I've looked, but I don't understand why they film it this way. Like, I will admit I'm not like an expert in event production, but this kind of setup I've never seen in an indie promotion. They usually try to maximize the amount of people that they can have in front of the Artcam, because of course they're indie companies, like they don't have a lot of people that are going to be in the crowd, so like trying to make the best of it, while OVW seems to be doing the opposite of that for reasons that I don't quite understand. But again, it's not a big deal. This was the breakdown of this episode. As far as I've seen, the show always looked this way. Even in the WWE days, the hard cam, the mic quality, the everything, like most everything except for like maybe the graphics, used to look somewhat like that. To the point where even their current World Championship belt is kind of a ripoff of the old WWF World Title belt, which is like usually it looks really cheap when indie companies take these replicas and apply some minimal modifications. But I actually like this one because it looks like it was custom made to look similar to the belt of WWF, instead of like taking a WWF belt replica and doing modifications. Yeah, if I had to give a grading to the production values of what I've seen, I would give it like a 5 out of 10. It's not grating, it's not like actively ruining the experience, this level of production values, but it could be a lot better than what it is, especially given the recent boost in popularity and likely money influx that they're getting from their newfound audience. Hopefully they use this money to upgrade Artcam, because as of now it looks kinda ugly. Alright, I guess that's it for this week's episode. Next week I will be discussing the NWA Power tapings, and that review may be a lot less kind, so to speak, than the one I'm filming right now, because spoiler alert, they have a lot of money, they are not really spending it at the best of their possibilities. But yeah, see you next week.